site. Let's go. Okay, so I made a burial beat on Twitch like a year and a half ago, and I never really finished it. So let's play around and see what we can do. I think right now I'm doing a little bit with Ozone. Yeah, so let's just sort of delete that. I've actually been producing a bit more into L1. I like the sound that I am getting from it, and I also find that it's still very transparent. It's not adding a lot frequency-wise. It's more straight-up, consistent volume across. But I need to find it first. Let me just type it in. I'm being silly. There we go. And I like to set this to 1.1 and 1. Just really just kind of takes that top dB before it, the threshold. Oh, whoops. That's supposed to be 0.1. You know, that top dB, you know, from 1.1 to 0.1, it's kind of just staging it before we hit the 0.1 where it's really smashing. And so that gives me like a little bit of safety. Will be kind of tied to whatever the sample is, so it seems like pretty on the grid. But I use the snare and the hi-hat, move that shit around a bunch, and we're good to go. Check where it's hitting. to a sampler, move the root note up to D, and now we can kind of play around with this, because I did pitch this kick, so we're going B, C, what, I guess we're on A minor? No, B, C, C sharp. Hold on, what am I working in? Let's see. What? Look at that. Embarrassing. Why is that there? Just make sure it's C. The second kick right here. If we're playing C, oh shh. I'm gonna stop cursing. Sorry, y'all. I can't. Fix this, and we're just gonna go up a note. That'll be fine. Okay, and so now it's time to decide where we want to play around with the snare. So, first of all, we're going. What is this? Trying to see like what kind of musical elements I can add to this, but I think let's just start seeing like where we can go with the snare. We'll be right back. point, though.